Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In the last video, we have used the ESP32 as a MQTT broker using the PicoMQTT library. And in this video, we will do the same thing, which is using secure and cheap MQTT broker on ESP32 using SimpleMQTTBroker library or SMQTTBroker library. We have already discussed in the previous video why sometimes using private MQTT broker such as Raspberry Pi is overkill. For example, when we have very small number of devices and very infrequent and not so important data, using Raspberry Pi or other private MQTT broker is overkill. For small scale IoT projects with limited resources, the ESP32 can be an excellent choice as an MQTT broker. So let's find out how to use ESP32 as MQTT broker using the SMQTT broker library, and let's look at the features of it. SMQTT broker library only supports the broker mode, whereas PicoMQTT library allows you to use ESP32 as a broker or as a MQTT client. Also similar like PicoMQTT, it supports MQTT 3.1.1 only. Also, since we are using it on ESP32, therefore it is light and fast MQTT broker. Also, you can secure your MQTT broker using username and password. Unlike PicoMQTT, it also supports quality of service 1. In this video, we will look at two scenarios like the last time. ESP32 as a MQTT broker, and we will connect it to the home network, that is our router, and all the devices will be connected to the same router. Another scenario in which ESP32 will work as a hotspot and all the devices will use ESP32 Wi-Fi access point to access the broker. Let's start with the first case. We will connect all the devices with our router and ESP32 will work as a MQTT broker. We are using a smartphone, Python client and ESP32 C3 as a MQTT clients, and they will be sending random numbers or random messages to our ESP32 MQTT broker. So we are in the Arduino IDE and the first thing that we will do is install the library. So you can search for SMQTT broker. And we will have to install this library. Currently we are using the 0.1.8 version, and then once the library is installed, you can go in the examples and you can search for the SMQTT broker library here, and for now we are going to run this simple broker example. So this is the basic code. So this line includes the header file smqttbroker.h, which allows us to use the simple MQTT broker library. Then we are creating an instance of SMQTT broker class named broker. This object will handle MQTT broker functionality. Then in the setup function, we are first defining the serial.begin with a baud rate of 115200, which will allow us to print serial commands on the serial monitor. And then we will define the SSID and password of our Wi-Fi. And then it will connect to the Wi-Fi, and once we are connected to the Wi-Fi, it will print the IP address which we will use to connect to our broker. And then we are defining the MQTT port, which is 1883, which is the default port for MQTT protocol. Then we are calling the broker.init function and we are passing the MQTT port. This will set up the broker to start listening for MQTT connection on port 1883. And in the loop, we call the function broker.update. This function checks for new MQTT messages, process them and maintains the broker operation. Now let's write our SSID and password and then upload the code. Now I will upload the code. Once the code is uploaded, we can go to serial monitor and we can see that connection is established and we got this IP address. So now let's do some test, and we will go to our Python client. We have used this in the previous video as well, and the code for this will be in the description. So we will change the broker address here, which is 178.32 and the port is 1883, and we will be publishing random messages on the topic Python. So now let's run this, and we are sending the messages. To look at the messages, we will open the MQTT Explorer. And here we will connect to the same broker. So I will copy paste the IP address here. So port number is 1883, so we will connect here. And so you can see the messages from the Python client and from the ESP32 client. So you can see that now we got a message from smartphone. So now our broker was not using any user and password name. So now let's make it secure using the username and password. So now let's look at code for the secure MQTT broker. So we are starting with the importing of the library, and then we are creating a username and password. So here we have set the username admin and the password high voltages for our MQTT broker. Then we are defining a new class called MyBroker that inherits from the SMQTT broker. And this will allow us to extend MyBroker, and we can add our own functionalities in this MyBroker class. And so we have defined few functions here. So the first one is we are defining a public method on event, and then we are using a switch case. So for example, the first case is whenever a new client tries to connect, so it will look for login username and password. So if the username and password matches, it will allow us to go forward. Otherwise, it will print invalid username or password. Similarly, if we lost connection, it will try to reconnect Wi-Fi. And then we have this case subscribe, which allows us to handle subscription. And then after creating this class, we are making an object of this class. And then the other code is these simple and the same one. So we are using the SSID and password. And then once it is connected to the Wi-Fi, it prints the IP address. And then we have changed the port number here to 9000, just to show you that you can use any different port number as well from the default one, which is 1883. And then we are initializing the broker function by passing the MQTT port. And then we are in the loop function, then we are calling the broker.update function, which will simply handle the messages and the processing of the MQTT functionalities. So after doing that, we will simply upload this code. And meanwhile, this code is uploading. I will change the values here since we have changed the broker port. So I will change it to 9000. And then since we are using the username and password, so I will uncomment this, and the user is admin and the password is high voltages. That's it. So now our code is uploaded and the IP address is same. So now we will run this. Now we have the username and password. So I will add that password was high voltages and the port number has been changed to 9000. And now let's connect. We have to put IP address here 168.178.32. And now we are connected to our MQTT broker. We forget to uncomment this line, so I will uncomment this, and now I will run it again. And now you will see the messages coming here again. Now let's try to send a message from our smartphone. If I will do it directly, it will not work, but first thing I will have to add the username and password. So you can see that I'm sending messages from smartphone as well. Now let's explore a different scenario where the ESP32 acts as an access point, creating a local network. Other devices can then connect to this network and communicate with the MQTT broker running on the ESP32. The devices that we are using are the same. Currently we were using our router, but let's say we do not have a router and we would like to create our own network using the ESP32 access point. How we can do that? So it is really simple. In the code where we are connecting to the Wi-Fi, which is this part of the code, we will have to remove this. We will paste this part where we are creating a soft access point called ESP32 hotspot, and we are creating the password, and then it will print the IP address. So now let's upload this, and you see the IP address has changed. But for example, if I will try to connect, run this script here now, we are getting a timeout error because the MQTT IP address has been changed. So, and also the network has been changed. So now I will connect my laptop to the other network. So if I will look at show available networks, I can see ESP32 hotspot here. So I will connect to it and I'm connected. And now I will have to change the IP address here. And now if I will run it, you can see if we are able to send the messages. So now let's change it here as well. .4.1, and I will make it bigger. Connect, and the Python messages are here. Now let's send a message from the smartphone, but first we will have to change the IP address in the smartphone as well, and we have to make sure that our smartphone is connected to the same network. So I will connect my smartphone to ESP32 as well. You can see the message from smartphone as well. You can also watch my previous video in which we use the Pico MQTT library. The Pico MQTT library allows you to use ESP32 as a MQTT broker or MQTT client. So you can watch that video. The link will be in the description or on the card above. In the end, I would like to mention about my book, which is now available on Amazon. If you're interested to learn more about ESP32 and build IoT projects, check out this book, or you can scan the QR code. Finally, if you have any questions or feedback, feel free to write them in the comments. And if you like the video, hit the like button. Share and subscribe for more such videos.